I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to have a fast look at how you can move a project from Premiere Pro into DaVinci Resolve. So here we are in Premiere Pro, and if I just scrub through quickly, you can see that we've got a wipe, a cross dissolve, a speed effect here, an iris, and then another fast motion speed effect over there. So with all of this going on in the timeline, there are two ways I can move this project over into Resolve. I can go up to the file menu and choose Export AAF or Final Cut Pro XML. Oftentimes I've found that Final Cut Pro XML exports the project with greater fidelity, but every once in a while I have found that AAF can do a better job. So it really depends on what combination of effects you happen to have in your project. So all you do is select one or the other, choose a location for it to be written, click Save. You'll get a translation report with one. With the other, you have various options, which I'm going to just leave unchecked. Go ahead and save that. I get an export log with that option as well. And now all I have to do is go over into DaVinci Resolve. And to import either type of project, all I do is go up to the file menu, choose import, and I'm going to choose the AAF first. Click open. I have a variety of options I could choose from. I'm just going to accept the defaults. Click OK. I get a complaint about one of 31 clips that couldn't be found. I'm going to click No. I don't want to search another folder because I know that that's going to be this title that can't be translated. So I get a log of what's going on, and a lot of people freak out when they see this because they think all this stuff has gone wrong. Really, any warning that is a yellow flag warning here is probably just letting you know that there's an effect in the project that could not be translated into Resolve. So that widget or item or whatever it is going to be imported with default settings. Scrubbing through that confirms that that's largely the case. I'm going to click close, and you can see that we've got our edited project. We've got those speed effects translated over. The wipe came in horizontally rather than vertically, so that's a bit odd, but the dissolve is there. And the iris apparently is not supported, so it just came in as a dissolve. But otherwise, I have a perfectly wonderful timeline that I can start working with. And the other way I have of doing this, I'm just going to undo a few times, is to import that XML sequence. Again, I get more options. I'm electing to use the sizing information this time around. Again, Resolve is complaining about that one clip not being found, the title. That's the single yellow flag. In this case, things have worked out a little bit better. I don't have to worry about that wipe coming in improperly. I've got my speed effects here and here. I have my zoomed in clips. And all of that is good. So at this point, I can pop over here, do whatever grading I want to do. I'll just copy that over. And then when I'm all done doing what I'm going to do, all I have to do is go into the deliver page, and I can open up one of my presets. In this case, I'm going to use the Final Cut Pro XML round trip preset and click load. Then all I have to do is choose the video format and codec I want. By default, these other options are hidden. By default, this setting is going to automatically render each clip as individual source clips. I want to click Select All Clips. Assuming all of this is correct, all I need to do is click Add to the Render Queue. Now, I didn't set a file destination, so I'm being asked to pick one now. I'm just going to choose Media Raid, OK. And now I've got this item in the render queue. When I click Start Render, All of these clips will be rendered as individual clips, and an XML Project Exchange file will be added to the destination folder where all of the media is being rendered. That XML destination file can be used to reopen this project back in Premiere Pro using the newly rendered media. For more information on editing and grading in DaVinci Resolve, check out my titles at rippletraining.com. My name is Alexis Van Hurkman. Thanks for watching.